Joining us live is Alex Ilagan, Executive Director of the Credit Card Association of the Philippines. Good afternoon, Alex, and thanks for taking our call.
Good afternoon, Rain. Thanks for having me here.
There's a fear that because of the lockdowns and unemployment that there would be a ballooning of non-performing loans. How has credit card payments been so far during this pandemic? Has there been an increase in cardholders who have defaulted in payments?
Well, as expected, the number of cardholders who are becoming delinquent has almost doubled compared to pre-COVID-19. You know, people are losing their jobs, businesses are closing down, so people are losing their source of livelihood. So we expect the number of cardholders who will default to increase further, especially with the modified enhanced community quarantine.
We're coming from what kind of figure, Alex? You said the number of delinquent cardholders has doubled. From what number?
Well, prior to COVID-19, it was just hovering at around 4% average for the whole industry.
Mm. Now, how many cardholders do we have now? How many cards does the average Filipino have? What is the average credit limit of those cards? And how much is the average transaction? How do these figures compare with the rest of the region?
Well, based on our last survey, there are about 11 million credit cards issued in the Philippines. But on the average, a cardholder will have about 1.5 cards, or 1.5. So that makes it about 7 million unique individuals holding a credit card. The average credit limit's about 30,000, 35,000, and the average transaction size would be about 5,000. That's probably comparable to the rest of the ASEAN region.
Mm-hmm. And is this pandemic or credit payment situation, does this encourage card issuers to issue more cards?
Well, on the contrary, banks will be more careful. In fact, some of them have started to tighten up their credit acceptance criteria because there will be riskier segments coming up, with people losing their jobs, their means of livelihood. So the likelihood of default will be higher. So naturally, banks will be more hesitant. They'll be more conservative in issuing credit cards.
Mm-hmm. Now, what does it mean to cardholders' financial standing and bank history if he or she defaults on payments?
Well, it will definitely be detrimental to the person's credit history, because all the unpaid credit card obligations will show up in the credit history. So if a cardholder will eventually apply for another card or apply for another loan, the likelihood of being declined is much higher. So you have to be careful about, maintaining a good credit history.
Now, how do we protect cardholders from unscrupulous collectors? We're hearing reports of collectors making threats, calling up cardholders several times in a single day. When does it border on harassment?
Well, we're trying to address this in two ways. One is we're educating our cardholders that, they should be dealing only with legitimate collectors. So what CCAP has done is we have published all the accredited collection agencies in our website. So any cardholder can check out the name of the collection agencies who might be calling them. And we also ensure that before a bank will transfer an account to a collection agency, the cardholder will have to be advised formally at least 7 days prior to the actual transfer. We're also doing a program now for collection agencies. So we recognize agencies who does well, not only in terms of performing in their collection responsibilities, but also in terms of keeping up with the ethical standards that we have set. So each bank have their own set of rules on what to do and what not to do when doing their collection. We also recognize collection agencies. We give awards every year to agencies who have the fewest number of complaints and who were able to maintain a good standard of performance in terms of customer service and satisfaction with the people that they're dealing with, particularly the delinquent accounts.
Mm-hmm. What about as cardholders find difficulty in making payments amid the crisis, what are the best options or tools open to cardholders to be able to pay down their credit card debt?
Actually, most banks have offered repayment arrangements post the MECQ. Most banks actually, well, all of them would waive the penalty charges, you know, that resulted from non-payment during the lockdown. And they also offer repayment periods of up to 12 months, in some cases interest-free, and in most cases offering lower interest than standard interest that are charged to delinquent cardholders. Well, in addition to that, CCAP also has an interbank debt relief program. This is for cardholders who have more than one credit card that has become past due. So we make it easy for them to go into a restructuring arrangement. They don't have to call everyone, all of the banks that have issued cards. They only need to call one bank, and that bank will take care of coordinating with the other banks. We also offer longer repayment terms and lower interest under this program.
You mentioned the interest rates. What is the prescribed interest rate right now? When do you know that it is over, or even the financing charges or other charges, maybe over what should be the industry standard?
Well, actually, interests differ depending on the type of program. Like right now, banks offer very low interest for installment purchases. Some of them even, with the help of the merchants, they offer zero interest for installments of 6 to 12 months. But when it comes to delinquent accounts, 2% or lower would normally be the expected rate for interest.
Mm-hmm. And what risks or threats are facing cardholders right now amid this difficulty in paying down their debts with the credit cards?
Well, we notice there's a prevalence now of fraudulent activities happening, especially online. So we're asking the cardholders to be more careful in sharing personal information, because some people would pretend to be representing banks and will call them and, you know, ask for confidential information like credit card numbers, expiry dates, even one-time PINs, you know, so they can. These fraudsters will use the card without the knowledge of the cardholder. So we educate the cardholders to be more careful in dealing with individuals sending them emails or calling them on the phone.
In which case, what is the recourse of cardholders who are faced with such risks like these? In case they try to work it out with the bank and they are unable to do so, can they seek help from CCAP?
Well, they should immediately call the bank issuer the moment they find out that their card was used fraudulently. So in most cases, when the bank can establish that there was no fault on the part of the cardholders, the bank would eventually end up paying for the loss.
At least there are still services that CCAP might be able to offer our cardholders with delinquent payments. Thank you so much for joining us today, Alex Ilagan of the Credit Card Association of the Philippines. We appreciate you sharing your insights with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Rin.